Accounts about the life of Captain Kidd vary. We know he was born in Scotland in either 1645 or 1654. Almost nothing is known about his youth, but by the time he was an adult, he was known as a heavy drinker with a bad temper. As a young man, he took to the sea, and eventually, through mutiny, he became the captain of a 20-gun vessel named the Blessed William after King William III. He and his men joined forces then with the British Royal Navy around 1690. They were commissioned to attack French warships. Captain Kidd made many gains as the captain of his own ship, but it was said that he did not share his wealth with his crew. He kept them hungry and desperate for a payout. The crew took on dangerous work without much in the way of rewards, so there was often talk of mutiny among them. Because Captain Kidd proved himself invaluable during the war between the English and the French, he was commissioned to police the American waters. He was supposed to protect English interests and attack any pirate ship in the area. However, instead of cruising up and down along North America's eastern coast, Captain Kidd sailed off to the Indian Ocean. He decided to become a pirate and began attacking ships. Word of Captain Kidd's deeds soon reached England and North America. When Captain Kidd returned to the North American coast, it was said that he stopped along the New Jersey coast to bury some treasure. He then made his way to Boston, where he was finally arrested and sent to London, England to stand trial. At trial, he was convicted of piracy and for the murder of William Moore, who was a gunner on one of Kidd's ships. And so Captain Kidd and most of his crew were found guilty of piracy, and they were sentenced to hang. On May 23, 1701, Kidd was placed in a wooden cart, and the parade of death made its way to Execution Dock in Wapping, London. Crowds of people lined the streets. Street peddlers were out in full force, as well as all the local pickpockets. Along the way, people would shout and throw things at the condemned. People also handed the condemned alcohol as a last act of compassion. The procession also stopped at a few pubs along the way to keep Captain Kidd and the other condemned men drunk and brave enough to take a stand at the gallows. This went on for over 2 hours. When Captain Kidd finally arrived at the gallows, he was extremely drunk. As was the custom, Captain Kidd was given the opportunity to speak his last words, and he went on to blame everyone for his current state of affairs. He also maintained his innocence. A noose was then placed around Kidd's neck. The step was kicked out from underneath him, and the rope broke. Captain Kidd said that this was a sign from God that he was innocent of the crimes of murder and piracy, but the hangman wasn't buying it. He was immediately hanged a second time with a stronger rope. Again, the step was kicked out from under him, and his body made the 6-inch drop into the slow strangle. His legs kicked about in the marshal's dance, and his death, like the death of the other men convicted of piracy, was due to asphyxiation. After his execution, the tide of the River Thames covered his body 3 times. Then his bloated and slimed body was cut down, coated in a layer of tar to prevent it from decaying too quickly, and gibbeted or hung in chains at Tilbury Point, where those arriving or leaving the Thames would witness it. His remains were left on public display for roughly 3 years. Some accounts state that his remains were allowed to hang until they were completely rotted away. Other accounts, however, state that he was eventually buried in England. The exact place is unknown. Thank you for watching my latest video. Please don't forget to give this video a like, and while you're at it, subscribe to Strange Ago to keep up with the latest videos covering our strange history.